It's your 50th anniversary at the Association of European Journalists. Happy birthday. For half a century, you have defended a free press and free expression in Europe. And that is a very important objective, and one we share here in the Commission. Because that's a fundamental right. It is a pillar of democracy, and it's something I'm determined to ensure inside and outside our borders. Hungary was one recent high-profile case, a case where we used our existing legal powers to the full. The story there is not over, but this goes beyond just one country. For example, I've deep concerns about the state of the media in Bulgaria. I've recently discussed this with the media representatives and with Prime Minister Borisov. I urge him to take appropriate measures, including for transparent ownership. But in fact, these issues are in play in many member states, to different degrees and with different emphasis. Look at the UK's Levinson inquiry, issues in Italy, or the debate about public service broadcasting in Portugal. In short, this is a subject worth taking and talking about across Europe. And indeed, defending media freedom and pluralism is often an area where the public expects the EU to act. We need to think seriously about whether the EU has sufficient powers in this area to meet that expectation. Two groups are doing important work in these areas: the Center for Media Pluralism and Freedom at the European University Institute in Florence, and the high-level group under Vaira Fiki-Freiberger. Both will deliver reports on which we can build. Because I want to launch a wider debate about this issue, with all those involved contributing frankly. Thus, more need to be done to safeguard media freedom and pluralism. Who should do it, and what are the best tools to use? Plus, there are many other questions facing the journalism sector today. How should we ensure confidence in independent, quality journalism? How should we respond to the opportunities and challenges of the internet? And how can quality journalism make the most out of new innovation and new potential business models with a fair share of rewards within the value chain? The AEJ can help us with all those questions. So congratulations again on your anniversary. And I look forward to working further with you to answer them.